In this tutorial, we're going to look at how we can create out these two amazing halftone photo effects design using Pixelate Color Halftone inside Adobe Photoshop. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. In the previous lesson, we have created these two amazing photo effects design using the Pixelate Color Halftone, but we have used threshold and created this nice, amazing photo effects. In this tutorial, we're going to use the same tool that is Pixelate Color Halftone, but for the first design, we have used channel attributes to get the effect, whereas for the second design, we have used invert adjustment layer. As you can see in our second design, you can see it's a little different from our previous designs. As usually when you apply halftone, you got that black dotted pattern. Whereas in this, we are giving white dots and this effect. So, and the background is black. So we have taken some different techniques and steps to get this effect. So let's begin with our designing process. So here's our first image we're going to create. So as you can see, we have given some nice halftone effects only to the image and the background is plain. So usually it's masked out. So on the layer, the first thing we can see over here is we have given a dark blue color to the fruit, and after that we have added some adjustment layer to make it bright. On top we have added a layer. This is a texture layer, halftone layer, and we have changed the blend mode to overlay. Usually when you made it to simple, this is the take, this is the image, right? So, and after that we have blended it to overlay. So let's understand how we have created this. So I'll open an image. Let's open it in Photoshop, and firstly let's crop this area. So we'll use the crop tool C shortcut, and with the alt pressed, I'm just making sure the area is getting smaller, and I'll place this in the center and press enter. Here we go, and I'll just convert this into smart object. Now, first thing, I'll change the image size. So I'll go to image, image size, and change the image size around 2000 pixel. Okay. And here we go. Now, next thing, I'll remove the background. So we'll use the selection tool. So over here, let's use quick selection tool, right? And over here, select subject. And this will select the subject in your image. And so over here, the grapes and the hand are the subject. So we want only the fruit part, and we want to remove the hand. So just paint over it and just remove this area, right? Just zoom it in and work on it. Now, to make the selection precisely, press Q and you got this red color. Now with using the brush tool, just paint on the region which we don't want to select. So I just paint over here and over here and overall. So I think overall it's looking great over here. Let's see. Okay, just paint over here, press X to choose white color, and just erase the red color over here. Over here also, let's erase the red color. So switching from black to white, you can use it as a brush or an eraser. So once you have painted all the area which we want to deselect, press Q again, and here we go, only the fruit region is selected. Now go over here selecting the layer and click on layer mask, and this will mask out the background. Next, we'll add color. So let's change this color to dark blue color. So I'm going to use this solid color. So go over here and choose solid color, and I'm going to choose around here and blue color, deep blue color over here around this much, and click OK. And we'll change this blend mode to color bond, and I'll clip this to the layer. So with the alt press, click make clipping mask, and this will be applied. And to change the color a little bit, we'll just go over here and let's make it a little bit lighter, just around this much. Okay, something like this, and click OK. Here we go. Now after this, select both the layers and convert them into smart object. And now next thing we're gonna do is to create that halftone pattern. So to create that halftone pattern, I'm gonna select this and go to filter, pixelate color halftone, and make sure all your channel values are different because we want those RGB colors, and we'll set the radius to 22 and click OK. And here we go, we have applied that pattern. Now what we want is we want only one channel. So I'll open the channel, Windows channel, okay, and under channel choose a one channel. Let's say you want a green color. I think green is a little dark, so we'll choose the blue color. I think this looks great. After selecting the blue channel, press Command A or Control A to select all and copy that. Command C or Control C to copy. After that, add a new layer on top and paste it. Command Control V and just place it in its position. And here we go. we got that nice pattern on top. And we'll create one more duplicate of this and just hide this one. And for this second layer, we'll just remove the halftone effects. And let's change the blend mode of the top layer to overlay. And here we go. Now, next thing we're gonna do is to change the colors using the adjustment layer. So we'll add some adjustment layer to this image. So first, let's apply hue and saturation. Okay, and let's change the color to a little bit. Yes, around this much. Make it a little bit darker. And let me make it a little bit brighter. Okay. So I've given around 29, 39, and let's adjust the color a little bit just to make a little bit purple color. Okay, that looks great. Next, I'll add one more black and white layer on top. So we'll go over here and choose black and white, and we'll reduce the fill value to around 60%. That way you got a nice little bit of hint of purple color, but you got that nice texture. Now I'll add a new layer on back, add a new layer. I'll just bring this on top and fill this up with the color, green color, this one. So the color code we have used is C4DCAC. Okay, so apply that color under the background and let's clip this effects to this image only. And that's how we have created that effect. Let's look at our image. This is our first image and this is our first image we have created just now. And over here, if you see on the edges, you can see that we have given that nice glow, and as well as we got this part where we haven't applied the color. So let's tweak that part. So first of all, here it is our image. Okay, first thing we're gonna do is to add inner glow. So I'll just add inner glow. We'll adjust the size around here. So let's see the image over there. If I reduce the size and a little bit increase, okay, you can adjust the opacity. So we want this around this much and size around that much, and I think it looks great. Next, I'll go inside over here and let's remove the color on this part. So under solid layer, we'll select the mask layer and with a brush tool, just paint black color to mask out this region. And after that, Command Control S, save it. And if you look it in our image, you got that effect, right? And I'll just go to inner glow and just reduce the opacity a little bit just to see that effect. Yes, something like that. And a little bit of size, little bit. Okay. And here we go. And lastly, you can add a curve adjustment layer on top. Okay, just to give some contrast to your image. Okay, something like that. And here we go. We got that nice halftone effect using the Pixelate Color Halftone and the channels. We have used the channels attributes to get this. Now let's create our second image, that is this one. So for the second design, as you can see, it's a little different from our previous designs. Usually when you apply halftone, your dotted colors are black and the background is white, but over here the background is going to be black and the dotted colors are white. So we have taken some different steps to get this effect, and we have used invert adjustment layer to get this. So let's look at it how you have created this. So this is a design we're gonna create. So let's open our image. So over here, open this in Photoshop. Then the first thing we're gonna do is to crop out the area. So press C and just crop out the area. Let's make it a little bit smaller from this side and from the top and bottom as well, and press it, enter, and here we go. So here's our image. Now let's convert this into a smart object. Now usually what we do is when we have an image something like this, we directly apply Pixelate Color. So what we want is this, right? So what happens if we directly apply Pixelate Color to the image? So let's see, filter, Pixelate Color Halftone, and we'll keep the channels to 000 because we want it black and white, and we'll set the radius to 22 and click OK. And here we go. So this looks good, but what we want to achieve is this design. And to achieve this, by directly applying halftone effect to the image, it's not going to work. What happens if I invert this? So I'll add an invert adjustment layer on top, and this will give you this effect, but this is also not what we are looking for. So by applying halftone effect to your image directly, you'll not get that effect. So let's follow different steps for this. So this is our image, right? Now the first thing we're gonna do is to invert the image. So let's add an invert adjustment layer on top. And here it is. Now, as you can see, our image is fine, but we are seeing some details on the background. So let's remove that part. So you will use the levels. So I'll go over here and add a level, right? And we'll increase the brightness. So I'll increase it to around 183, 182. And let's add a little bit darkness, right? Around this much. And we'll keep this level below our invert layer. So levels, then invert layer, something like that. So this is the settings we have given. We have set it around 182 and this one around 32, 31, something like this. And after this, select everything and convert an image to smart object. Okay, now when we apply halftone, let's see what happens. So selecting the layer, I'll go to filter, pixelate, color halftone. Keep it 22,000 and click OK. And here we go. We got that nice dotted black color with a background white. But we want to get this. And this should be white and the background should be black. So what should we add? We add another invert adjustment layer on top. So over here, when you add an invert adjustment layer, you got that interesting looking effect. And if you see our image, you can see that everything is nicely balanced in this design. And over here, we got some patches over here. And to remove that, we'll go to our image layer, this one, double click inside, and let's add direction blur or motion blur. So we'll go to filter, blur, and let's say motion blur, something like this. So we have given around, okay, 126 and click OK. And if you save it, Command Control S, and check our image, here we go. We got that interesting looking design. Right, this is the color halftone, and here we go. And if you want to do a little bit more tweaking over here, you can add Gaussian blur to this image. Let's say blur, Gaussian blur, okay. And if you add a little bit blur, and after that we'll add a threshold on the top, okay. You can give some different effect to your image, something like this. Let's go over here and adjust the Gaussian blur value as well, a little bit around lower range, and threshold, play around with the threshold. So it's all depends on you. So I think for this design we don't need the Gaussian blur, and we can just play around with the threshold just to get that effect. And here we go, we got that nice looking design, something like this. Let's add the text, right? So I'll just bring in our text from here, drag and drop and place it around here. Now let's crop the region, make it a little bit smaller. And here is our second design. Very simple, very easy. Now let's summarize this tutorial. So in this tutorial, we have used Pixelate Color Halftone to create our halftone effects, but you need to use different other attributes and adjustment layers to get your effect what you want. So each time you use different adjustment layer with a Pixelate Color Halftone, you get some interesting looking halftone effects. In the first lesson 1 and 2, we have used filter gallery halftone patterns, and using that we have created 4 amazing designs. And for the third and fourth tutorial, we have again created 4 amazing designs using the Pixelate Color Halftone, but each time we have used different other attributes and adjustment layers and given some amazing effects to our images. Now in the next coming up tutorials, we're going to cover 2 more topics: how we can use bitmap option to create halftone effects, and how we can use threshold option, especially the threshold option, to create some amazing halftone effects. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.